The Exemplary Husband by Stuart Scott. Chapter 1. A Husband's Understanding of His Present Condition. A Personal Testimony. I remember a time early in our marriage that was a turning point for my wife Sandra and me. It all started with one little statement that she made to me one evening after an especially hard week as a mother of two young children. "You are being very selfish," she said. I'd never heard Sandra speak so pointedly to me before. At first I was speechless. She should not be saying this to me, I thought. I tried desperately to figure out what I had done that was so terrible. Where did that come from? I asked after the momentary shock wore off. How can you say that? I was a young pastor at the time. I had been through both Bible college and seminary. In fact, I was studying through the husband's role in marriage when this occurred. She must be having a bad day, I rationalized. Before I could think of something else to say, she continued, only now she was in tears. You seem to care almost exclusively about your own desires, circumstances, and interests. Now that we have children, I can't focus totally on you anymore. The truth is, you act as if you couldn't care less about my circumstances. Do you realize that we never seem to talk about what concerns me? For the most part, you aren't willing to sacrifice even in the smallest ways for others, unless it costs you nothing or it serves your interests. And on top of that, do you realize that if I have to ask for your help with anything lately, your reaction shows your impatience? I really think that the concern and interest should go both ways. So that's what this was about. You're just upset because I was tired and didn't really want to wash the baby bottles, aren't you? You know how difficult things have been for me this week at the church. Besides, even though I didn't want to, I did wash the bottles, didn't I? Thinking further about Sandra's statements, I became defensive. I thought, surely you have the wrong person. Are you talking to me? Your provider and protector? How can you so misjudge me when I am such a good husband to you? Blinded by my own pride, I set out to inform Sandra of the ways that I loved her sacrificially, the way Christ loves the church. As my mind sought examples, however, I was thoroughly stumped. I mentioned a few things I had done for her. But the truth was, I did just enough to get by and there was often a kickback for me. The more I evaluated my love for her, the more I realized that convenience or putting on a show for others to see was almost always involved. As much as I hated to admit it, she was right. I was consumed with myself and my own interests. I remember the moment of those realizations as if it were yesterday. I was like King David when he was rebuked by Nathan the prophet, 2 Samuel 12-1:13. My mouth had been silenced by Sandra's words. I had never really loved my wife the way I thought I had. I came to realize that although I believed that two shall become one, I, of course, was the one. There followed a week of unforgettable grief and remorse. It was as if my pious world had come crashing in on me. The realities about my lack of biblical love were earth-shaking ones that I continued to recognize in all areas of my daily living. I began to see what others must have long since observed in my life. Thanks to my dear wife, who loved me enough to tell me the truth, God began a much-needed work in my heart. Since then, I have been much more aware of my pride and selfishness. Repentance began through that incident and is a continuing process. Instead, I could be likened to a simple frog slowly being transformed into the form of her prince, not yet rid of all his warts. The intent of this account is to illustrate my need for understanding concerning my love for Sandra. Like a builder preparing to build a home, I had to do some personal surveying before I could establish where I needed to begin building. I was lacking in true concern for her interests. My selfishness was a lack of mature Christian character. I have entitled this book, The Exemplary Husband, because of its emphasis on a man's walk and character. The word exemplary sums up the husband's responsibility in marriage to live what God instructs. Only one other word could describe it better. That word is Christ-likeness. More as a goal than a full reality, Christian husbands must answer the call of God to lead the way in pursuing Christ's likeness. In doing this, a husband will participate in the building of God's kind of marriage, and more specifically, God's kind of husband. God's will for Christian husbands. God's will for every Christian husband is to shepherd and love his wife the way Christ shepherds and loves the church, Ephesians 5:23-33. In fact, Christian men are called to follow Christ in all their ways. The one who says he abides in him ought himself to walk in the same manner as he walked. 1 John 2-6. Christ is our perfect example in all things. We have been given many other examples in the scriptures as well. Some are good examples and some are bad ones. We are given good examples that we might clearly see God's pattern. Bad examples show us wrong patterns. By these poor examples, God is seeking to reveal what is often difficult for us to recognize in the middle of our own circumstances. God uses both good and bad examples to move us toward His own likeness. God not only wants us to look to the right examples, but He also wants each one of us to be the right kind of example for others. We need to remember that we already are some sort of example to others. The question is, what kind? The following are charts of scriptures about Christ, our perfect example, and our need to be exemplary. As you read them, you will see that God has spoken clearly and powerfully to us about exemplifying Christ. Following the perfect pattern. You may be amazed to learn how much the scriptures have to say about examples. You may also feel that a biblical example is a shoe you could never fill. In the scriptures, the Greek terms for example, typos, pattern or model, hypodeigma, and imitator, mimetes, are key words. Typos in particular can shed much light on our endeavor to be exemplary. This word carries with it the assumption of an accompanying guide. It was used to refer to the tracing or practicing of one's letters. A clear example of this definition is seen in elementary schools across our country. Our children learn to write the alphabet by first seeing the letters, which serves as their guide, then by tracing the letters, and finally by attempting to form the letters freehand. The emphasis of this word is not necessarily on the perfection of the resulting copy, but rather on the careful attention given to the perfect example and on the determined purpose of following it. Likewise, we as husbands must be focused on our perfect example, the Lord Jesus Christ. We must carefully and purposefully strive to copy Him, no matter how inadequate our attempt may be at first. As we continue to grow in this endeavor, we will be exemplary. There will be more and more of a resemblance to Christ that others can follow. As the Apostle Paul said, "Be imitators of me, just as I also am of Christ." 1 Corinthians 11:1. So what does it really mean to be exemplary? From our study so far, we can put together a working definition. To be exemplary is to serve as an improving copy of our perfect pattern, Jesus Christ, by deliberately focusing on and practicing His likeness. the fruit, traits, of the exemplary husband. It is God who produces real fruit within the heart, Matthew 7:17-18, Galatians 5:22-23. Only the heart that truly knows and walks with God can even begin to look like the heart of God. A husband will bear good fruit in his character and work only when the thoughts and intentions of his heart seek God, love God, and desire to glorify God. Such a man will leave behind a legacy that will continue to be an example long after he is gone. Who can be the exemplary husband? Not that I have already obtained it, or have already become perfect, but I press on so that I may lay hold of that for which also I was laid hold of by Christ Jesus. Brethren, I do not regard myself as having laid hold of it yet, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Philippians 3:12-14. Whatever condition you believe your heart and life fruit to be, you need not or must not remain in this condition. To be an exemplary husband, you must first be in a right relationship with God. Then, you must recognize that growth is needed and purpose to begin following your perfect example. Next, you must realize that sin is the only thing that can stand in your way. You should take great hope in this truth because sin can be confessed and turned away from with God's help. No Christian husband is destined to be a slave of his flesh, helplessly bound by his past or personality type, nor helplessly affected by poor examples lived before him. Once one accepts responsibility for his own sin, he can change through God's provisions. Romans 12:2. See the God's provision of sanctification section of chapter 3. So who can be the exemplary husband? Any Christian man can. Are you ready? Becoming the exemplary husband will be a growing process. In the end, we want to look like Christ. Each husband must do his own honest survey of his heart's condition before he can begin to build an exemplary life. Next, he must acknowledge God's perfect standard and determine his commitment to pursue it. You must count the cost of following Christ. It will most certainly cost you your own will and always getting your own way, because we cannot have both God's way and our way. This fact must be recognized at the outset of the commitment to build an exemplary life and marriage. There is only one thing that will truly motivate man to follow Christ's example. That one thing is knowing Christ himself. In other words, it is a right relationship with God that produces a desire for Christ-likeness. You must truly be one of his disciples, or you will not be able to be an exemplary husband. Of course, a right relationship with God is based on an accurate knowledge of him as he is revealed in the Bible.